The addition method is also another way to solve systems of equations. This method is especially useful if you have equations in the form ax plus by equals c. As in the case I have here, 6x minus 5y equals 25 and 4x plus 15y equals 13. So it would be difficult to use the substitution method here because it wouldn't be easy to solve for x or y in either equation. You would get fractions. So the idea of the addition method is this. Consider you had two things that were equal, like a and b, and you had two other things that are equal, which were c and d. Now, if I added the left side together, I would have a plus c, and if I added the right side together, I'd have b plus d. Now, first of all, you should convince yourself that if a and b are really the same numbers, and c and d are really the same numbers, then if you add a plus c, you'll get the same answer as if you do b plus d. This is the idea of the addition method. If you have two equations and you line up your equal signs, if you add the left sides of each equation together, and then you add the right sides of each equation together, you'll get another true equation. Now, looking at this particular example I have, if I added the left side together, I would get 10x plus 10y equals 38, which really isn't any more useful than either of my original equations. So we don't indiscriminately want to just simply add the two equations. We want to alter the equations in such a way so that either the x terms are opposites or the y terms are opposites. Okay. So I look at the x terms and I see I have a 6 and a 4. First of all, they're not even opposite signs, okay, and secondly, they're not the same, you know, coefficients. They're not both 6 or they're not both 4. Now for the y terms, we have a negative 5 and a 15. They are opposite signs, but one's 5 and one's 15. So what we would like to know, is there a way of multiplying either the top equation, the bottom equation, or both equations by something in order to make the x terms opposites or the y terms opposites? All right, there are several ways to do this. Basically, if you look at the coefficients of x or you look at the coefficients of y, you're looking for the least common multiple of those numbers, because that, if they were both that coefficient, then you would have opposites. So for instance, look at the y's. I have 5 and I have 15. So if both of them go into 15, that's the least common multiple of 5 and 15. So if I could make them both, one of them negative 15 and one of them positive 15, that will achieve my goal. So let's go ahead and do that. How would I do that? Well, I already have a positive 15, so if I multiply the numerator by 3, I'll also have a negative 15. So this gives me a new equation, because I'm multiplying all the terms by 3. I'm going to have 18x minus 15y. Now remember to also multiply the 25 by 3. Okay. Now I don't need to multiply this by anything, so I'm just going to copy it. If you want to think of it as multiplying by something, you could say 1, but basically you're just rewriting the same equation. 4x plus 15y equals 13. All right. So the goal was to either get the y terms to be opposites or the x terms to be opposites, their coefficients. So now when I add the left side together, I have 22x equals 84. And that's the idea. I eliminated the y variable. That's why this is sometimes called the elimination method. Okay, now I have to finish solving for x. Divide both sides by 22. Now 2 goes into both of these numbers. So I've got 42 elevenths. Oops, I made a mistake. I added 75 and 13 and got 84, but it's really 88. So let's correct that. So we have 22x equals 88. So if we add the left side, we get 22x, and if we add the right side, we get 88, and then we can divide both sides by 22 to get the value of x. I don't know what this is, 2x I wrote. X is 4. Now, that's actually not the answer to the problem, so we might not want to write a box. We do know X is 4. So this tells me the X value in the ordered pair. All right, now, how do I find the Y value? We could actually go through this whole process again, eliminating the X values. That's one way of doing it. Another way is you go back to one of the original equations, not the 18X minus 15Y equals 75. So I could go back to either of the original equations and replace the X value with 4 to solve for Y. So let's say I took the second equation, 4X plus 15Y equals 13. And I'm going to plug in 4 for x. And simplify the left-hand side. Subtract 16 from both sides. Gives me negative 3. Divide by 15. And oh joy, we have a fraction. But remember, fractions are numbers too, so it looks like the y value is negative 1/5 if I didn't make any mistakes. Okay, let's check and see if that really is the correct solution by plugging in 4 and negative 4 for x and negative 1/5 for y into both of the original equations. So now we have to check that order pair into both of the originals. So one of them was 6x minus 5y equals 25. So we're going to check it in here, and then we're going to check it in 4x plus 15y is 13, and do the arithmetic. So we have 6 times 4 minus 5 times a negative 1/5 equal to 25. Now, we have a minus sign and a negative, so that's going to be plus, the 5's cancel, 1, right? Equals 25, so that's true. 25 is 25, so it's certainly a solution to that equation. Now we're going to do 4 times 4 plus 15 times negative 1/5 equals 15. We have 16 plus, all right, what happens here is the 5 cancels and the 15, I get 3, and then 3 times negative 1 is a negative 3. Okay, I actually wrote 15, but actually the equation is equals to 13. Okay, so we check the other equation is 16 plus 15y. I'm sorry. So we check the other equation, which was 4x plus 15y equals 13. We're going to put in 4 for x, negative 1/5 for y, gives you 16 plus, all right, let's see, this reduces to a negative 3, and 13 equals 13. All right, so we've checked our answer. So 4 negative 1/5 is the correct solution. Please watch Systems Part 8 for another example solving a system using the addition method. It includes a slight variation on how to find the solution when the first variable you solve for is a fraction.